myself Suhasin Pandey from Tagore Public School, Surajgarh. As I have delivered different lectures in the Human Physiology of Class 12th RBSA, as in the discussion in Chapter 25, in previous lecture I told you about the human excretory system. Excretory system related with the excretion of the different types of excretory products. These excretory products are of in the form of ammonia in case of lower organism like protozoans, sponges, and urea in case of higher animals including the human, frogs. According to the excretory product in few animals, uric acid as excretory product is found, like in case of snakes, birds which excrete uric acid. On the basis of excretion of the such type of excretory product, animal name has given. If animal excrete ammonia, called ammonotelic animal. If animal excrete urea, known as ureotelic animal, including the human being and other mammals. Animal includes uricotelic if excrete uric acid, like birds, snakes. Sometimes the question arises, what is the unit of kidney? So unit of kidney is called as nephron. Unit of kidney is called as nephron. Nephron mainly has two important parts. One nephron has mainly two important parts. One part is called as glomerulus. As first part is glomerulus and second part is called as renal tubule. As the glomerulus, which generally has two important parts, one is generally called as the afferent arterioli. As afferent arterioli, which is larger in diameter, this is afferent arterioli, and next one is efferent arterioli. Efferent arterioli, which has less diameter. Afferent arterioli, which power the blood in the glomerulus. As glomerulus is the branched structure which contains generally squamous epithelium in the inner wall. This squamous epithelium present in the glomerulus. As glomerulus has branched structure, so glomerulus branches have squamous epithelium tissue. From the squamous epithelium tissue of the glomerulus, which is branched structure which has seen here, the blood from the squamous epithelium enters in the empty places, and by the empty places this blood now causes a pressure on the a cup like structure which is called a Bowman capsule in the nephron. This is Bowman capsule. As Bowman, one scientist who first of all told about this capsule,
Hence, the name has given as Bowman capsule. In the Bowman capsule, ultrafiltration has done. What is means of ultrafiltration? As the filtration has done by very small size diameter of the pore present in the squamous epithelium of the Bowman capsule. Here, in the Bowman capsule also, presence of squamous epithelium by which the blood generally shows the ultrafiltration. As ultrafiltration occurs here, this is the process of ultrafiltration which generally occurs in which the filtration of blood occurs from the glomerulus to the Bowman capsule. Due to the high pressure, as the afferent artery which has large in the diameter, here afferent artery has shown with the large diameter in comparison to the efferent artery. So the blood collected in the Bowman capsule continue due to the less diameter of the efferent artery. Here efferent artery has less diameter, so blood collected in the Bowman capsule. Now this blood absorbed by help of special columnar epithelium tissue present at the position of the coiled structure which is called PCT. PCT means proximal convoluted tubule, which is present near the Bowman capsule. And this Bowman capsule and PCT, DCT parts are considered in the form of renal tubule. So renal tubule has many parts, like one part which is cup-like structure called as Bowman's capsule. Another part which is present near the Bowman capsule is called PCT. Next part which is away from the Bowman capsule is called DCT. At the PCT, PCT means proximal convoluted tubule. Proximal convoluted tubule. As proximal convoluted tubule generally present near the Bowman capsule. This is the position with the Bowman capsule. So PCT is near the Bowman capsule where one phenomena occur, where the absorption of nutrient occur. So absorption of nutrient occur at the PCT part of the Henle lobe. Here at the DCT, which is completely known as the full name of DCT, is distal convoluted tubule. Distal convoluted tubule as full name of DCT, where the process occur as reabsorption. So at the DCT, process of reabsorption occur, and here reabsorption of water occur at the DCT part of Henle lobe. Here the two parts are confined in the human kidney. As the outer part, which is present the outer side, which is called as cortex part, and the inner part, which is called as medulla part. These cortex and medulla, two important parts present in the kidney. So according to this, in the structure of nephron, this is the structure of nephron. As I told you that the Bowman capsule, this is the first part, PCT and VCT, these three parts of the nephron present in the cortex part, but one part which is called Henle's loop, which is found in the medulla part of the kidney. As efferent arterioli, this efferent arterioli, which is branched and generally present around the Henle loop, makes a tubular structure which generally takes part in the absorption of the different types of nutrients. This tubular structure around the Henle loop called vasa recta. Vasa recta is very much branched, coiled, tubular, and vertical to the Henle loop. Vertical length to the Henle loop present, and which generally takes the nutrients from the such type of filter which is related with the globulus, and this is also has very small size diameter. Here this generally takes the blood away from the Bowman capsule. Bowman capsule, which generally has a type of cup shaped structure, this is called Bowman capsule because it is discovered by the scientist Bowman. So it is cup shaped structure where ultrafiltration takes place. Ultrafiltration occurs in the Bowman capsule by the much blood collected due to the more diameter of afferent arterioli. This has much diameter in comparison to the efferent arterioli, which is very less diameter. So blood collected continue in the Bowman capsule, and due to this if type of pressure occur, continue blood reaches downward in the descending loop. This is descending loop which comes from the PCT in the medulla part. In the deep medulla part, such Henle loop is present. So Henle loop, which is found in the deep medulla part, is called as medullary Henle loop. This is called as medullary Henle loop because such type of Henle loop reaches deeply in the medulla part. But in few cases, sometimes the Henle loop is very small size, which only present in the cortex part of the kidney. Such type of Henle loop is called as cortical Henle loop. Means Henle loops are of two types. One which reaches deeply in the medulla part called as medullary Henle loop, and one which is only limited in the cortex part called as cortical Henle loop. As the pressure increases in the bottom of the Henle loop, means here the pressure is maximum, as it is about the 1200 mmHg. Pressure is about the 1200 mmHg at the bottom, but the pressure is very less in the cortex part. Here the pressure is in the Henle loop is about the 350 mmHg. So very less pressure is found in the cortical part, and this pressure increases continues. This is the 650 mmHg at this position, and the 550 mmHg here. So regular increase of the pressure, but the ascending loop where the such type of fluid reaches upward, which generally has the a type of tubule, which is known as DCT, where the reabsorption occur. DCT, full name is distal convoluted tubule, where reabsorption of water occur. But at the PCT, which has the columnar epithelium tissue, and PCT, full name is proximal convoluted tubule, which takes part in the absorption of nutrient. But the question arises, what are the nutrients which absorbed by the PCT? So nutrients which absorbed by the PCT are mainly, these nutrients are in the form of glucose, which is the monomer of carbohydrate. Different types of nutrients which are mainly in the form of glucose, as next one in the form of amino acid. Amino acid, which is the unit of protein. This amino acid is the unit of protein. And another is fatty acid. Next one is glycerol. So, as fatty acid and glycerol, which are the monomers of the fat. These are monomers of the fat. So monomer of fat are fatty acid and glycerol. But amino acid, this is the monomer of protein. Monomer means a simple unit of the polymer. So glucose is generally called as monomer of carbohydrate. Monomer of carbohydrate in the form of glucose, which generally absorbed in the form of nutrient by the PCT. And PCT, full name is proximal convoluted tubule. This PCT, which is present near the Bowman capsule, as cup-shaped structure. Here, this is the Bowman capsule, which is cup-shaped structure, in which the blood filtration process is called as ultrafiltration. Question arises, why it is called as ultrafiltration? Because the blood filtration occurs by the very minute pores, which is present between the squamous epithelium cells. Squamous epithelium tissue, which is present a single layer, which cells are generally lens-like, spindle-like, between two cells, small pore is present by which ultrafiltration occur and blood collected in the Bowman capsule, which has shown here by help of small arrow. This is the ultrafiltration. After ultrafiltration, then the absorption of nutrient in the form of glucose, amino acid, fatty acid and glycerol occur by the PCT part, which is coiled structure and present near the Bowman capsule. After absorption of such type of nutrients, the water present in the fluid and the nutrients also absorbed by the mixed coil structure of the efferent arterioli, which is called a vasa recta, which also absorbs nutrients from the Henle loop. But the remaining part is water, which is reabsorbed from the DCT part. So water, reabsorption of water occur and the fluid amount is very less, which contain urea, which contain the less amount of water. It means much concentrated urine, which passes in the large diameter containing tubular structure. called collecting duct. In the collecting duct, different DCT part attached. Like this is the one part of nephron, this is another nephron DCT, this is next nephron DCT. So many nephrons attached with the collecting duct. From the collecting duct, which reaches the medulla part, where the medullary pyramid opens in the calyx part, and calyx part opens in the renal pelvis. So collecting duct opens into the renal pelvis. From renal pelvis, such type of filtrate in the form of urine now opens into ureter. As you know, ureter, which is one pair present in the human excretory system, which opens in the urinary bladder where urine collected, and within 24 hours about 700 to 800 ml urine collected in the urinary bladder. Such urinary bladder has a bladder-like structure and surrounded by the three layers. Outer layers of urinary bladder made by the peritoneum epithelium. Middle layer is made by the striated muscle, and innermost layer, which is present innermost in the urinary bladder, made by the mucous layer. As the space present inside the urinary bladder in which urine collected, which reaches out time to time through the urethra or through the urethral pores outside, which is called micturition process. As I told you earlier that nephron is unit of kidney. Nephron is considered as unit of kidney. It is called unit of kidney. One kidney has how many nephrons? This is the question. So one kidney contains about 1 million nephrons. It means 10 lakhs nephrons. So kidney contains about the 1 million nephrons. 1 million nephrons present in the one kidney. Here one kidney has 1 million nephrons. This is very important question in the board examination and for competitive examination like the NEET, AIIMS, etc. So you remember that one kidney has 1 million nephron, I mean to say 10 lakhs nephron. And next question, what is unit of kidney? This is also very important question may ask in the board examination. Sometimes it is previously asked in several years in the NEET examination. So answer is, nephron is called a unit of kidney. Now next question, what are the many important part of a nephron? So answer is, nephron has two important part. One is called as glomerulus and another is called as renal tubule. As renal tubule and glomerulus are two important part of the nephron, it is clear. But sometimes question arises, what are the part of the glomerulus? So glomerulus made by the branched structure of afferent arterioli and efferent arterioli both. So glomerulus has two parts. One is afferent arterioli, and the other is efferent arterioli. Next question, what are the differences between the afferent arterioli and efferent arterioli? So it is clear by help of diagram here, afferent arterioli, which has generally the large diameter, it contains large diameter in comparison to the diameter of the efferent arterioli. This is the difference as first difference, but another difference is afferent arterioli which power the blood in the Bowman capsule or which power the blood in the glomerulus, and efferent arterioli which takes the blood from the Bowman capsule. Here it has clear that this is the as branch structure of the efferent arterioli which take the blood from the such glomerulus part, and afferent arterioli which provide the blood to the such branches, as these branches again divided into many thin branches, but each branches contain the squamous epithelium in the glomerulus branch. This glomerulus branch is generally called as the glomeruli, and the squamous epithelium has special type of cells which shapes are generally spindle shape, as the gap present between two cells has a small size pores. By these pores here in the diagram has shown that blood enters in the empty place as different branches of the glomerulus. Then these blood collected which causes high pressure in the Bowman capsule. It means like a large tank when filled by the large diameter pipes and small diameter pipes which takes the such tank water outside. So it is clear that the water remain in the tank continue. Such condition arises here in the Bowman capsule. Blood which filtrate form present and reaches in the PCT. Reaches in the PCT means proximal convoluted tubule. Here the meaning of proximal means the nearest to the Bowman capsule, and convoluted means it is much coiled structure, and tubule means the shape is tubular part. So full length is proximal convoluted tubule or PCT, which important function is absorption of nutrient. I have discussed already, these nutrients are in the form of glucose, which is the monomer of carbohydrate, amino acid, which is monomer of protein, glycerol and fatty acid, which is monomer of fat. So monomer of fat, these are glycerol and fatty acid. These are monomer of fat which also absorb at the PCT part of the Henle loop. Here Henle loop, which generally as the very thin tubular structure, is called Henle loop, which is present in the medulla part. But above this, the large size tubular structure, a part of PCT or either a part of PCT. As the Henle loop, which generally the vertical tubular structure continue reaches deeply in the medulla part. If the Henle loop which reaches deeply in the medulla part called as medullary Henle loop. It
is called as Middlebury Henley Loop and Henley Loop branch or Henley Loop tubules are of two type. One tubule is collected the filtrate from PCT and reaches downward. This downward loop is called as descending loop. And one loop which takes such type of filtrate upward direction, this is called as ascending loop. It means Henley loop has generally the ascending means upward and descending means downward direction. So descending loop now reaches deeply where the maximum pressure is found, as the pressure is 1200 mmHg. What is mean of mmHg? mmHg means millimeter at mercury. So this is the type of osmolality. This is the type of osmolality pressure, and such pressure decreases again when the ascending loop reaches upward, then pressure decreases, and this ascending loop now reaches in the broad coil form structure called DCT. As DCT, full name is distal convoluted tubule, where the reabsorption of water takes place. What is benefit of reabsorption at DCT, and what are the names of the factor which regulate the reabsorption at DCT? So one hormone secretes by the posterior lobe of pituitary gland called as ADH. ADH means that is the antidiuretic hormone. Antidiuretic hormone is ADH, which secretion occur abundant or large scale, then much reabsorption occur at DCT part in the nephron, so urine become much concentrated, and this much concentrated urine contain urea which collected in the collecting duct, which collected by the collecting duct. Urine collected in the collecting duct reaches to the medullary pyramid and calyx part, which opens into the renal pelvis. Renal pelvis opens into ureter. I told you earlier lecture, ureter opens in the urinary bladder, which collect about 700 to 800 ml, means 800 ml urine in it, which comes out through the urethral tubules under the neuroendocrine control. Through the urethral pore, urine comes out. This phenomena is called as micturition. It means nephron control the as formation of urine and micturition process and ultrafiltration process. So three important process has done. Beside this, in the nephron, due to the presence of a special type of tissue which is present in the glomerulus as juxtaglomerular cell, or it is called as JG cell. If the juxtaglomerular cell which stimulate to takes part in the absorption at the DCT, it has noticed that about 70% reabsorption occur and only 30% reabsorption occur at PCT part. So reabsorption control by the juxta
glomerulus cell or JG cell, which is present in the glomerulus part of the glomerulus, which is first part of Henle loop, and the renal tubule part as PCT and ECT takes part in the absorption and reabsorption like process. As such absorption occur after the ultrafiltration in which the such blood by the kidney Bowman capsule, where the small pores present between two cells in the squamous epithelium tissue of Bowman capsule, such blood reaches by such small pores, hence it is called as ultrafiltration. So in this way, as complete lectures of the structure of nephron has discussed. Please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel Super Classes. Thanks very much.